Grandma, what was life like for you before the war?
Life was good. In the village, there was school, there was businesses, people were some are traders, some are doing their businesses. Normal, just normal village life.
How did it change once the war started?
That time, there was no market. There was a market, but the market would start from around 5 a.m. to 6 to 7. By 7:30, everybody has gone. No movement because of plane. If the plane has, the plane are flying, what will we do that time? The tortoise. Immediately you hear the sound of plane, take cover. Wherever you find yourself, you enter bush and lie flat on the floor, on the ground. You won't even care what is there until the whole thing is over. Then people will start coming out from the bush again. Movement will start. There was school. School stops. That's how we stop going to school. That time I stopped going to school. Every other person stop going to school because nobody will go to school. Nobody will, there will be no gathering.
How did you feel about the fight?
It was very bad. If I would, nobody should even mention it. Because I lost my parents. My father joined the army and never didn't come back to today. And because my mother, in fact, that was the first time I heard about stroke. She was to go to take her bed early in the morning. She fell down. She shouted. I rushed there. I saw that she was on the floor. I managed to get her up. That's why she didn't walk. She didn't talk. After 1 week, my mother died. Two of my brothers joined the army. And the day they came back home, it was really, they looked like skeletons.
Do you think it was right for people to create the Biafra?
It wasn't right because the Biafra people were not prepared. They had nothing. They were fighting, they have no gun. They were fighting, they have no bullet. Even some soldiers connived with the other, their enemies to do what? To kill their own brothers. We used to sing some songs that time. One and one name for Ogami. Abirego, Ifa Jonare Rani, Iwo, one and one name for Ojogo, one napotano Zore, one near. So the army officers were even doing what? Selling their members. Sometimes the army officers will go and connive with us. They will give them food, give them money, give them everything. And they will tell them we are their own soldiers doing what? Camped. And they will go there and do what? Finish them. So to me, it wasn't good. It was, in fact, nobody even mentioned anything about war to me.